Hi, I'm Jonathan, an artist from Germany. Over the last days and weeks, I've been changing my content from tutorials to a more narrative-driven style, in the hopes of being able to take on bigger projects and document them in vlog-type videos. This does not mean I'll stop making tutorials, but rather allows me to create them less often and only about interesting topics. If you want to follow this journey, consider subscribing because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with that said, let's get straight into this week's progress. Just like the last week, this week started pretty slow. Leo and I continued work on a little app we started in a stream almost 1.5 weeks ago. But it wasn't until today, Saturday, that we actually made some good progress. In the meantime, I spent some time making music, which in the end led to me and Leo releasing a small song pack on Gumroad that includes 5 synthwave tracks. You can hear one of them in the background right now. For such a product, we of course needed some artwork. And because I'm still an active Blender user, I started work on a cover a few days ago. We needed something that somehow resembles synthwave. And because I'm still me, I wanted to pair it with some abstract designs. It's always a good idea to find some reference, so after searching for synthwave artworks, this color palette became the one I used. Because this sun symbol is one of the most used ones, I tried to replicate it in Blender. The process was actually extremely easy. You can see that this is everything I got. We have 2 of these sun objects, one with a glass material and the other one with the color palette I just showed you. The same color palette is also mapped across a background plane using a linear gradient and a color ramp. Now again, in these videos I will not go extremely in depth and show you every step I made to achieve this result, but I will show you the most interesting things about this project. Again, as I said, the whole process was pretty simple. I started off with just a simple circle and filled it and extruded it using a solidify modifier. Using this object, I booleaned out these stripes. If you want to create this kind of pattern, you can just use an array modifier with an object offset and scale up your empty. This way the arrayed object scales up with every duplicate. Now, the interesting part is actually how I rendered out this project. Because in the end, I wanted to try pixel sorting with this artwork. But this pixel sort effect should only be applied onto the sun. And this is where render layers come in. Render layers is a concept I have never talked about on my channel. You can see in the top corner right here that we have different scenes that allow us to make completely new scenes or different view layers. And you can see that I have one called sun and one called background. These 2 view layers allowed me to separate the sun from the background. And in my hierarchy, you can easily see how I did it. I put both of the sun object into a collection and the plane object into a collection. Because view layers are mostly synchronized, which I can quickly show you, if I disable this area lamp right here, it will also be disabled in the other view layer. But there are a few things that are view layer specific, and these are visibility options for collections. If you right-click a collection, you can see that under view layer, you can either disable them, enable them, or set indirect only. For the background view layer, I just disabled the sun collection. In the sun view layer, I had to set it to indirect only. This way, only already reflected light rays are being rendered. This allows me to render the glass with its correct attributes. In the compositing tab, you can just use an alpha overnode to merge both view layers back together. You can select them right here. Using the file output node, you can also save each view layer every time you render. This way I was able to isolate the sun and then apply a pixel sorting effect to it. And in the end I was left with this image. And I personally thought it looked pretty cool. After finishing up all of the songs and uploading them to Gumroad, I went back to working on the app. The plan was to create a Stream Deck app that allows us to wirelessly change scenes in, for example, OBS. I finally was able to understand the Python socket module, so after some coding I was left with a first prototype. The next step would be the design process, which I will be streaming live on my channel next week. Hopefully this new type of content is enjoyable. If you have any feedback, please let me know in the comments below. This really helps me out. And we will see each other next Saturday or even in a stream next week.